In this segment, I want to go through two examples and look at a couple new functions that you're going to be able to use for the homework and will be useful later on in the course. So let's look at the first example, where I have this function x that's a function of t. So x is equal to -2t² + 6t + 28, and we're trying to find what the maximum value is of x, and at what value of t this maximum occurs. Now it's a polynomial. We could use calculus, find its derivative, set the derivative equal to 0, and that will give us the t at the maximum or the minimum of x, and then we can plug that t back into the original equation to find what the maximum value of x is going to be. So if we want to do this analytically, that's how we could proceed, but we can also do this numerically in MATLAB. So if we come over here and look, I have some of this already set up. I'm going to look on the interval from t is -5 to 5, and I'll start with just 20 points between -5 and 5 for t. Okay. And then I define x using that function -2 × t² + 6t + 28. Notice here that, again, t is a vector, and x is also going to be a vector. For every value of t, I'm evaluating the value of x at that value of t. So here, just note in the definition of x that I'm using dot arrow 2 to square each term of t individually +6 × t + 28. So if I look in my workspace, or if I look in the command window here, I now have 20 values of t, and then I also have 20 values of x. Right, so one way we could find the maximum, now that we have values of t and values of x, is I can plot x versus t. Let me make this a little bit bigger here. So this is that function x from t is -5 to t is +5, with 20 points of t in between. So there's a couple things I can look at here. One is if I go up here at the data cursor, I can move along the different data points graphically and see what the value, the horizontal value and the vertical value are at each of those points. So I'm using the left and right arrow keys here once I click on the plot. I can move along the different plot points that I've made here. So I can't quite get to the actual maximum, but I can at least get a rough estimate here that the maximum is going to occur around the t value of 1.316, since that's the horizontal component, and the x value will be about 32.43. Again, this is kind of a rough estimate, but I can actually improve this if I go back to t here and I increase the resolution, meaning I have more values of t that I'm going to evaluate this at. So I'm going to rerun this whole segment here, pushing F9, and I'm going to get a smoother curve here, and we'll also see that when I use the data cursor and I push left and right, it's a much finer detail of where I'm going. So using the data cursor here, I get around the same value here, 32.5 for my x value, 1.47 by eyeballing it for my t value. So that's using the data cursor. I can also use a tool called Ginput, which if I type in the command window Ginput, push enter, it's going to bring up this plot, and it gives me a crosshairs here. And what Ginput is I'm going to line this up where it looks like the maximum is. I'm going to left click the mouse, and if I push enter on the keyboard, it's going to give me the coordinates that I just clicked with my mouse. So again, this gives me a rough estimate of where that maximum is going to occur. So at 1.53 in the t and 32.4 in the x is my approximation here by eyeballing it. So this is graphically how I can see where the maximum is, but I can get numerically determine where this maximum is using another new function here, the max, which is going to behave like the min function also. So if I type help max here, and I see how max is used, what I give max is I'm going to give it a vector, although it also works with a matrix, but if I give it a vector of values, max, like the name implies, is going to give me what the largest value is. And actually there's two ways to use max here. If I look down here, if on my left-hand side I have two variables in brackets. The first variable it gives me is the value of the maximum, and the second variable it gives me is the index, or which element number is the maximum in that array. So let's see how it works with our function here. Let me clear the screen. So I have x. It's this vector of now 100 elements since I redefined it. If I come down here and I run just line 79, it gives me x max is 32.5 approximately, and what I'm calling ind, it says that the index where that maximum occurs is 65. So at the 65th element, I have the maximum value, and it has the value of 32.5. Now what this also lets me know is, then I can use that information to find at what value of t is that maximum. I know that occurs at the 65th value of t, but I want to see what is the value of t at the 65th value. So on line 80 here, if I run just that line, I'm finding t of 65, or the 65th value of t, occurs at 1.46. So at 1.46 seconds, I get my maximum value of x, 32.5 approximately. And if we go back to the figure here, that's very close to what we got by eye using either the data cursor or using Ginput. And what we can do to get even more resolution here is I can go, instead of 100, I can put in 1,000. And in MATLAB, you can use scientific notation here. So 1e3, lowercase e3, means 1 times 10 to the third, or 1,000. So if I rerun this little segment of code here, it gives me, again, a much finer resolution. This tells me that at 1.4 or 1.5 seconds, which is the 650 index, I get that the maximum value that x takes is 32.5. And then this is the same answer, or about the same answer, I would get using the calculus method and the algebra method for this polynomial. Now, if I look at the second piece here, I'm using another new function here. But first, the setup is I want to find the sum of the multiples of 3 up to the number 63. So what I can do here is find what are all the multiples of 3 up to 63, and I do that down here when I define this vector q. So again, I'll clear the screen, get rid of all my workspace. And I see here that I've defined q using that colon notation to start at 3, go up in steps of 3 this time until I reach a value of 63. So if I look at the vector it gives me all the multiples of 3 up to 63. So 3 and 6 and 9, etc., up to 63. So this is the vector of values for the multiples of 3 up to 63. Now to add them all together, either I could type it in manually, I could say it's 3 plus 6 plus 9 plus 12, etc., and go all the way up. But more conveniently, I can use the sum function. And again, it does pretty much what the name implies. It takes the sum of values in a vector, or you can use it to take the sum of values in a matrix. Here, I can use it to take the sum of values in a vector. So if I want to add up all the values there in Q, which are all the multiples of 3, again, if I take sum of q, I get 693, which is what I would get if I added each individual element in the vector q.